Good morning, everybody. I have another great pleasure today to introduce another excellent speaker for our module for Chinese law and intellectual property law, coordinated by Professor Xu Jianfeng. That will not be the pleasure of me, but you will meet very soon. Today we have with us Dr. Xu Lin from the State Administration of Industry and Commerce, Trademark Review and Adjudication Board of the People's Republic of China. This is another very excellent presentation that complements the previous presentation we had from the judge, Dr. Zhang, and from Dr. Wei.
It's my great pleasure to be here to give the brief introduction of Chinese trademark law. And I'm very happy to say that all the students here are so handsome boys and so beautiful girls. So it will make me much more happy. Okay, let's start. The title of the speech. The title of the speech, the registration, use, and protection of trademark in China. Every person may get contact to hundreds of trademarks a day. For example, when you get up, you may choose your toothbrush, and you may choose to drink what kind of milk, what brand of it, and choose the shoes, choose the clothes. And when you go out, you can drive the car of BMW or just a Honda. And when you go to the office or school, you open your computer. It may be the brand of IBM or the brand of Apple. When you want to have breakfast, you may go to the McDonald's or KFC. So, whether you noticed or not, you live in a world of trademarks, and the trademarks do really influence our lives. It's very important for us. Here's two questions. First, what the trademark is, how to define the trademark. Why should we protect the trademark right? First, I think the trademark is a stable perception sign which is used by the producer, operator, or service provider on its own goods or services to identify themselves and distinguish from others. There are several elements of this definition. First, a trademark is a stable perception, which means it can be perceived stably. Before the new trademark law, the trademark that can be registered in China is limited to visual designs. But this time, with a new amendment, we add the sound. So the sound can be trademark. Also, in some other countries, the smell can be trademarked. So, any signs that can be stable perception have the possibility to be the object of trademark. But now in China, we have limited to several kinds, not including the smell or some other kind of sign. The second element is it is used by the producer or operator of services provider on its own goods or services. This means we call the trademark. It's not just the mark. The mark have to adapt to the product. Then it comes to the trademark. it's only a character if we talk about this mark. But when it is put on this mineral water, it's a trademark. So we can't talk about trademark without the goods or phrases. The third and the most important one is the function of the trademark. The function of the trademark is to identify the producers and distinguish from others. As we know that in old days, people buy things just from the producer face to face. But as the development of commodity economy, there are plenty of products in the market and there are much more producers. So how can a computer find the product he really wants to buy? Or how can a producer distinguish itself from others? So it comes the trademark. It's the normal forms of trademark. We usually can see the word, this one, the word, devices, the Apple computer, letters, IBM, IBM, numbers, 3D, McDonald's, combination of colors. Just one single color cannot get registered in China because there are only less than about 100 single colors in the world. So if the single color can get registered, maybe that's only 100 holders. How about the other person? So in China, just the combination of colors and the sounds, as I just mentioned, is newly added to the trademark law. Article 9 of trademark law. A trademark seeking registration shall be so distinctive as to be distinguishable and shall not infringe upon the prior legitimate right of others. The prior rights of others. First, you have to be distinctive. Second, you cannot infringe the prior rights of others. That's the two main principles for the signs eligible to registration. First, let's say distinctiveness. Distinctiveness of signs by itself. As we see, apple, hair, Sony, it's just the sign have the distinctiveness. But the examples I give to you is not the sign have distinctiveness of by itself. The second is too simple. It's too simple and can't be registered. The second is too complicated. The customer may recognize it as part of the packaging of the goods instead of trademark. And the first, just a letter A. There are only 26 letters in the English language. So we think that just one single letter in this form, in this form cannot get registered. So the distinction, as I just mentioned, we can't talk about trademark without good. So when we talk whether a sign can register, whether it has distinctiveness, we have to think about the good, which means Apple can use as a trademark on computer, but Apple cannot use as a trademark on juice, on fruit. Okay? The left is a registered trademark. Honghe means Red River. First letter Red, second River. And the right trademark is Red River, right. So, generally, we are similar. And we can see that the defendant used the Red River rubber, right, on beers. And it's a listed company. So, the court of first instance think that there's the infringement and sentences the compensation for 10 million RMB, nearly $202 million. And the court of second instance made the same sentences. But the company appealed to the Supreme Court. And the Supreme Court think that, first of all, the defendant are located in a county named Red River. So the purpose we use the Red River rubber red is on good faith. Second, the plaintiff cannot provide any evidence of use, which means there's no Red River beer on the market. If there's no Red River beer on the market, where's the confusion comes from? And if you do not use your registered trademark, what's your loss of the infringement activity? So the Supreme Court just sentences 20,000 IMB from 10 million to 20,000. So use is very important. Even you get registered, if you do not use, when you ask for protection, maybe the court can cause others to stop the activity, but you cannot ask for money because you cannot prove the loss of you. You do not use it, there's no loss. Okay, chapter medical treatment. People get illness. Trademark meaning sometimes for medical treatment. That's the protection of the trademark. Trademark protection system. As far as I know, in America, in Europe, in England, in Italy, in France, the trademark protection is from the judicial procedure. Just the court to make the decision. But in China, there are two procedures. In 2008, the trademark filed by Chinese is 5 190,000, but in last year, it's up to more than 2 million. And Chinese is the number one in respect of trademark filing and registration for 11 years. I don't think this number one is good, especially for the examiners. Article 56 of trademark law. The exclusive right to use a registered trademark is limited to the trademark which has been approved and to the goods which the trademark is to be used. Which means if you get registration, then you can use the trademark. How to use? Just the trademark you get permitted. You cannot change the trademark with the registered sign R. Also, you can use it only on the product, on the registration certification. Also, of course, you can use on other goods, but you cannot use the R. Means you get registered. But when you get registered, others not only can't use the same trademark on same goods, others cannot use the similar trademark on similar goods, which means the reach of the right to forbid others is wider than the right to use. So, in China, trademark law system is very necessary for the company to apply for registration as early as possible. This procedure, the trademark office will notice the registrant and the right holder will provide the evidence that I have used it. If you failed to apply the evidence, you do not use, then the trademark will be cancelled. So you lost the trademark. Procedure for invalidation. A trademark, when it gets registered, in 5 years, people can go for TRIB to ask for invalidation. Grounds on absolute conditions, such as not distinctive contrary to public interest, anyone can start the procedure and with no time limit, even 10 years, 20 years after the use of the registration of the computer, of the trademark. Such as aspirin, you know aspirin?
Yeah.
It's a medicine, but it used to be a trademark. But it's so popular that the consumer calls medicine aspirin. So it lost the distinctiveness. So it is invalidation. In case of conflict with prior right, on relative grounds, 5 years from the date of registration, the right holder or interested party can start the procedure. Also, no time limit for grounds on absolute conditions or bad faith registrations of well-known trademark. Effect of invalidation and cancellation is different. Invalidation invalid. Invalidation, the trademark is invalid from the date it gets registered. But cancellation, the trademark right terminates as from the publication of the date of the cancellation, which means invalidation, the trademark is not, cannot get registered from the beginning. So if the trademark is invalidated, it will come back to the date of your registration. But cancellation, your registration is no problem. Okay, but the use of the trademark may be such as aspirin, so popular, become the less the distinctiveness, or just the trademark, you don't use it for 3 years and it is being cancelled. So the cancellation is from the date the cancellation publication. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you very much.